हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे वी शैल स्टडी सिविक्स ऑफ क्लास सिक्स। टॉपिक इज डाइवर्सिटी एंड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शैल लर्न अबाउट व्हाट इज डाइवर्सिटी एंड व्हाट इज डिस्क्रिमिनेशन। डाइवर्सिटी मीन्स डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन पीपल ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कास्ट, रिलीजन, लैंग्वेज, स्टेटस, जेंडर, फूड हैबिट्स, ड्रेस एंड एक्सेट्रा। एंड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन मीन्स अनफेयर ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ पीपल ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ जेंडर, कास्ट, रिलीजन इज कॉल्ड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन। नाउ वी शैल डिस्कस व्हाट इज प्रेजुडिस। प्रेजुडिस इज अनफेवरेबल बियास्ट opinion about some people or group of people, it is called prejudice. Its literal meaning is prejudgment, prejudging someone. For example, we see that in our society boys are given toys as tanks, guns, whereas girls are given twice as dolls. This shows prejudice in our society. A stereotype, it is fixed image of persons or group of persons, like we stereotype the Muslims as they not interested in the education of girls. And now we shall discuss the causes of discrimination in our country. First, gender. Gender is the main cause of discrimination, because you see in our society women are paid less than men. Girls are not considered to be educated. Their education is not considered important. And you also see that in our country sex ratio is deteriorating, as mortality rate is the lowest in the world. So there is gender inequality in our country. This is the main cause of discrimination in our country. Now we shall discuss inequality. Inequality is of two types, social inequality and economic inequality. Social inequality, we find that in still our villages we see that untouchables are not given the seat as the upper caste in the feasts where they can't eat together. So we see that there is high caste feeling, low caste feeling in our society. This is social inequality. Now economic inequality is, as in our country poor are becoming poorer and the rich are becoming richer. There is a huge gap between the rich and the poor. It is economic inequality. It is not good for our democracy. Inequality, it divides our society on the basis of status between the rich and the poor. Again, we see that caste system has been the root of the discrimination in our country. You know that our society is divided on the basis of caste. The upper caste, like the Brahmans, Kshatriya, Vaisya, Shudras, upper caste dominates the lower caste people for centuries. Although our constitution after independence has abolished untouchability, but it is still going on in our rural areas. And fourth is religious differences in our country, as we see that in our country the Hindus are dominating the other religions, as Hindus are above 80% in the country. There is the instances, examples of religious intolerance. This is not good for the country, for the democracy. Now we shall discuss striving for equality. It means that after independence, our government has established our constitution. They have given 6 fundamental rights to all citizens of India. First fundamental right is right to equality. Right to equality means all people are equal before law. No one is above the law. No discrimination on the basis of caste, religion, gender, or any basis. Second fundamental right is right to freedom. It means that all people can move in any part of the country. All people can follow any religion. All people can settle in any part of the country. They have freedom of expression. They have freedom to organize any institution. They can open any institute. And above all, they have freedom to follow any occupation, profession of his choice or her choice. Number three is right against exploitation. It means that no Indian can be exploited. We see that there is forced labor in our country. People who are in debt are forced to do work without pay. It is not good for our country. So no exploitation is provided in our constitution for all citizens. Now number four right is right to freedom of religion. It means that all people are equal before law. All people are considered equal in the eye of religion. There is no religion. There is no state religion. It means that no, in our country, all religions are treated equal. All people can follow any religion of his or her choice. They can also propagate it. Number five is cultural and educational right. It means that all people have right to have culture. They can follow any culture, Hindu culture, Muslim culture, or Christian culture. Again, we see that in our country, we have freedom, we have the right to have education free of cost. It is the most important right to our citizens. All people who are studying in government schools have free of cost right to education. The government is entitled to giving this. Now number last, we see that right to constitutional remedies. If any fundamental right is encroached upon, if any person or government snatches any fundamental right of any citizen, they can go to the court. It is the duty of High Court or Supreme Court to provide the people the fundamental right. Now we shall study that inequality still exists in our country. We see that the instances I have earlier told you, that there is still untouchables are not treated well, especially in rural areas. They are seated in that separate row during the feasts. This is discrimination on the basis of caste. Our government in constitution provided Article 17, which bans untouchability and declares untouchability as punishable offense. And Article 15 gives that no person can be discriminated on the basis of caste or religion, status, or any kind of discrimination. Article 46 tells us that people should preserve the economic and educational interest of the weaker sections of the society. The government will do for the work welfare of the socially economically backward people of India. Already they have given the reservation for the SC scheduled caste, ST scheduled tribes, OBC to enhance their standard of living, their empowerment in the government. Thank you for the next period.